नमस्ते सर।
जनरली गुरु शिष्या हैज टू गो एज पर गुरु ट्रेनिंग
हाँ नो नो आई एम
एंड
फाइन, आई एम फाइन, नो प्रॉब्लम।
नो सो I agree with what you are saying, not agree, I rather understand that what you are saying, it is Sakshi's Swaswarupa Gnana, ultimate.
Correct.
But up to now, whatever Gnana it was getting was from the Chidabhasa, by identifying itself by the image of the Chidabhasa.
Right.
And whatever Gnana it was getting is from the Chidabhasa. So, when Chidabhasa, when it is looking at Chidabhasa, then through Chidabhasa's reflection, it is looking at mind, mind's object, and everything else. But knower, if I, the real knower or the knowing is all at the Sakshi, isn't it?
See, Chidabhasa is Sakshi only. See, don't bring the duality of Chidabhasa and Sakshi.
Chidabhasa, so why?
Because see, light reflected from sun is sun only, sun's light only. Because reflection, we are using the word only because of to give a mirror analogy.
Yes, I mean that way actually. So is mind. So is all others are all reflection of consciousness only.
Correct, 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 correct. So. Okay, let us say Chidab, the knowingness always comes from Sakshi or Brahman. Brahman is the only knowing principle. Correct.
Right. So, in the end, if you see, everything is consciousness only.
Correct, correct.
In the explanation, the doubt that I, you said yes to what Katchain is saying, and you are saying no to what Vasudev is saying, which is correct, that it is not unconscious. That is the real consciousness. That final knowing of Sakshi knowing itself is really the real conscious Swagnana.
Swarupajnana.
That is reflected consciousness.
Right.
What? Correct?
Correct.
Now, the explanation that Dakshiniji is giving, up to 9, she is okay. 9 and 10, needs some explanation. Even in 10, in point 10, she says, it knows. Now that it is not, and she says, Sakshi doesn't know anything.
9, when this happens, Vidyavarti cancels the Avidyavarti, correct? That's what is 9, point number 9.
Point number 9.
Right.
With knowledge, it knows that.
It stops knowing objects as real, is correct only. It's because objects are unreal.
But 10, what is the it in the first point 10 means? Is it Chidabhasa?
It now knows that it is same as original Kutastha, which is actually, Kutastha is nothing but a Sakshi only, no?
No, yeah, that is right. I'll say that reflection now knows that I am the sun.
I am the sun, correct.
But that is not, that is not what. Up to there, it is this associative meditation, associative meditation. Up to there, it is still in Parikalpa. But once it leaves the image and knows itself without the.
It is Nirvikalpa. It is Nirvikalpa.
So, it is not the Chidabhasa or the reflected Chidabhasa, but it is there, the 9 should be Sakshi.
Nine is actually what happens that time there is no separation between Sakshi and Chidabhasa. It is merged, no? It is same, no?
Its continuity is that it is the Mayavik Brahman which is up to now knowing. Now it left the Maya.
Correct. So now there is no two, no? Now there is no Sakshi and Chidabhasa.
Chidabhasa merged in Sakshi.
Yeah, that from that point of view, I said it means I accepted that as a Chidabhasa and Sakshi are one now.
So that process is different from the process until. So Vasudev's first question was, in my experience, which is also my experience.
Wait a minute. I'm just opening what they were saying. Okay. What is this?
Vasudev's mail was that in my experience, I know only up to 9, but in fact up to 8. But the 10 is not the same. I nanembudu nanu Allah. That nenu is not the nenu anymore. That nenu changed to reality. That nanu changed to reality. And therefore, I am not that I. It's known only there, correct?
Speaking of point number 9 or 10?
And speaking of point number 10, it is different. I mean, that it is there. The I up to there was in the Mayavi zone.
Correct. Agreed.
And the 10, it is actually in the reality zone.
Yes.
So, for a person who is doing this meditation, he is only going as he only up to 9.
At the 9, okay, the understanding has dawned that all jagat mithya is over.
Yeah, so that's right.
Correct. So now after that I cannot separate out, no? That Chidabhas and Sakshi I cannot separate out.
You are seeing from not separate out. I am saying the process was different. That is what probably his question was. Now the consciousness is different. The consciousness changed from Vastu to Swarupa.
Correct. Agreed. See, Vasudev, I am reading Vasudev's mail, right? All recognition happens with the dream character, correct?
Correct.
But the dreamer lying on the bed does not recognize anything because he manifests as the characters in the dream. That's also correct.
That's also correct to some extent, right?
No, not some extent. It is correct because he doesn't recognize. He doesn't know anything about dream because the dream is he only.
Yeah, dream is he only. Correct.
Is realization an unrecognizable process, therefore unconscious, because the Brahman there is no other, right? So this is the answer. Is realization unrecognizable process, therefore unconscious, because the Brahman there is no other,
correct? So the that unrecognizable process for the dream character, correct?
He is asking from the Brahman point of view, because Brahman, from the Brahman point of view, first he spoke of the Brahman. Brahman does not know anything. Right? He said,
okay.
He said Brahman is sleeping. The Brahman is equivalent of the guy who is sleeping. He doesn't even know there is some realization at all. He doesn't even know there is a dream character. There is nothing.
He is the only knower. Okay. So that is what you said.
Right? So Brahman is sleeping. He has no idea about the Maya.
Okay.
Because he is the Maya.
Yeah.
Right? So now, next step he is saying, Vasudeva, is realization an unrecognizable process, because the Brahman, there is no other, right? So from Brahman point of view, there is no realization, there is no Maya, both.
No, Chadim, that is what I am also, in a way, Brahman knows that he was in Maya all the time.
No, see, Brahman is nothing but Jiva. Brahman in Jiva is Maya. Brahman in Maya is Jiva.
Correct.
But at the same time, the original nature of Brahman is unchanged, because from Brahman point of view, there is no manifestation.
Correct.
So we are speaking of two realities. One is Maya reality and absolute reality.
Correct.
So first statement is about absolute reality. Brahman is unconscious. Brahman does not know, and that's why realization is unrecognizable, unconscious from Brahman point of view.
In that case, this sentence is realization an uncognizable process, therefore unconscious, because for Brahman there is no other. Now, you are saying that this is from Brahman's point of view, it is correct.
From Brahman's point of view, it is correct.
Correct.
Okay. Right. Brahman's point of view, there is neither realization nor nor mukti nor enlightenment.
Yes, but it is an unrecognizable process even for the actual Brahman knowing is unrecognizable. Process even for the dream character.
No, the dream character, right? See, that's the key. That's where the key of Jivan Mukti. Jivan Mukti, dream character recognizes I am Brahman.
Correct.
But he recognizes Brahman as not an object, but myself, subject. That's a clear knowledge.
Okay, so what you're saying is the recognition is only for the dream character.
Dream character.
Only for the dream character.
Correct.
Okay.
So, now I'll tell you why this answer I gave, because there are many times people say, realization is useless because dream character wakes up as Brahman. There's nobody to realize. Hello?
That is what my thought also.
All right. There's nobody to realize, okay, is what is the normal interpretation. Correct?
That was my interpretation also.
No. What happens is there was never anybody. It was only Brahman all the time. But the individual character appeared thinking that I am a separate entity. Right? He forgot Brahman and he has entered into Maya. He has individuality. Right? In realization, he recognizes his true nature as I am Brahman. Okay? So now, here two things happen. One, there is a clear understanding arises using buddhi, using mind. That I am Brahman. There is a clear knowledge that I am Brahman. Where the definition of I is not the body, not the mind, not the intellect, but the self, which is...
For the self of consciousness.
There is an object. No, there is not a subject. There is no object, there is a subject.
Yes.
The subject is Brahman. There is a recognition and this is a conscious recognition. Because unconsciously you do it every day in the sleep. So this conscious recognition is what eliminates all the vasanas.
Okay. So for conscious, you are saying conscious at here by conscious you mean it is at the
jiva.
Dream character level only.
The dream character, see Brahman, there is no point of realization, no. From the jiva recognizes consciously, I am Brahman. Jiva. Jiva, my Swarupa Jnana, my Swarupa is Brahman.
The dream character?
Dream character, see, dream character is nothing but, Chidabhasa is nothing but Brahma, Sakshi only. Okay? See, there are two parts to Chidabhasa. One is Chidabhasa and the thought, ego. Ego is unreal. The Chidabhasa part of ego is real, it's Sakshi. No. See, jiva means I am body concept with the reflected consciousness, right? That's what jiva is.
Correct. As long as it is identifying with the mind.
Huh? Huh.
As long as it is identifying with the mind.
Mind. Okay.
Looking at the mind.
It yeah.
Not
but
the,
see that.
The, I'm looking at Kakshi. Or
see, the jiva has two components, right? Jiva has a component, two components. One is Chidabhasa. And other is a thought. These are the two components mixed up in jiva.
Correct.
The thought component is mithya, unreal.
Correct.
The consciousness component is real, which is nothing but sakshi.
Yes, the consciousness is sakshi.
Correct.
Yes.
So now, there is a recognition by the jiva that I am Brahman.
But that is of that consciousness part.
The consciousness part only, but it is done by using the mind.
No, in this part, ego also a role?
Correct, that's what I'm saying. See, the mana eva karanam manushyanam bandha mokshiyo, right? The mukti also happens in the mind, right? How does the mukti happen in the mind? The mukti, bandha is because I am the body, I am the mind, I am the intellect. That ignorance is there. Mukti means, I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am not the intellect, I am Brahman is a clear knowledge. It is a vritti. Vritti, where vritti can come, it is in the mind only.
It's in the mind only.
Correct? That vritti is called vidya vritti. The vidyavrati happens in the mind only. The vidyavrati only helps you to get out of avidyavrati.
Correct. Until the process of realization is happening.
No, this is
once
the
realization.
See, here realization you have to understand, you have to define very clearly. Okay. So now, see, mind is an instrument for recognizing any object, right?
Correct.
See, if I say a flower, I say it's a flower, it's a vritti, thought.
Correct.
It's a knowledge, right? That means there is knowledge of the object.
Correct.
So now, in realization, there is a knowledge takes place that I am Brahman. Okay?
By who? That knowledge is
By the jiva, the knowledge is always a jiva, no? Vritti knowledge is always a jiva only.
That part of knowledge is actually happening is because of the light of sakshi.
No, it's always light of sakshi only. Chidabhasa is nothing but light of sakshi only, reflection only.
Correct.
So now the mind has become so silent. That's actually what you call as sattvic mind, pure sattva.
Correct.
Right? Rajoguna is gone. All the vikshepa is gone. Projection is gone. Tamoguna is gone. Projection is gone. Tamoguna is gone.
Okay.
When the projection is gone, tamoguna is gone, there's a clear knowledge that I am Brahman. There's a jnana. There's a sattvic. It's not a projection. It is a clear knowledge. It's a vritti. It's called Brahmakara vritti.
Knowledge.
It is Swarupa Jnana.
So this is the Swarupa Jnana.
Okay, that's Swarupa Jnana is a vritti only.
It is all objective knowledge.
No, Swarupa Jnana is vritti only. So Swarupa Jnana ultimately has to come as vritti only.
Then it is not subjective knowledge. No, it is objective knowledge.
No. Here you have to understand, I am Brahman is the Swarupa, is a vritti. First, that is clear. It's a thought.
Correct.
But here the definition of I am, okay, changes from all objects from body, mind and intellect, all the objects are gone now. That's not an object.
Correct.
So what remains as a pure subject is called I in that knowledge. That's why it's Swarupa Jnana.
Correct. Agree. Huh? This is exactly the whole confusion is that word it in the point number 10. That
it
is no more the it of 9.
It is it of 9 is what? 9 is when this happens, vidyavrti cancels the avidyavrti. That does, right? It stops knowing the objects as real. Who is it? Which is chidabhasa, right?
That's right. That's chidabhasa. But it stops. Up to now it was knowing the objects. Okay, maybe the it of the previous one. Up to now. It is having objective knowledge, but at 10, it stopped getting objective knowledge, or its objective knowledge is transformed to subjective knowledge.
No, it stops knowing objects as real. That's also correct. Objects are unreal.
That means it is just not looking at any of the mind objects. Correct.
There's nothing to look at because they're all unreal.
So he's not looking at, but he's now looking at through the sakshi, he's looking at his pure image.
It is a pure, it's pure, there's no image now because it is image and sakshi has become one.
So there is no face there which is looking at its own pure image?
There is nothing to look at now. Image is not there now. Image is the original. Image is
from an intellectual point of view.
No, image is actually the sattvic mind is pure. 1 minute, sir. Some incoming call is there. Just 1 minute.
Sorry.
Hello.
The person you have called is speaking to someone else. You can wait or call again later.
Neevu kare madutiruva vyakti.
Hello?
Sorry, Prabhu.
No problem. See, when the mind has become pure sattvic, right?
Yes.
It's a clean surface. There's no distinction can be made between the reflection and the original.
That is what I'm not able to understand.
See, the reflection is different from the original only when there's a distortion.
But it is same. Reflection is same as the original, but it is not one and absolute equivalent of original, no?
It is, no? There's no distinction at all now. You cannot make a distinction now. Because if the reflecting surface is clean, right?
Hmm.
That crystal clean reflecting surface is called sattva guna.
I understand. But then the mirror analogy doesn't hold this what you are saying.
No, no. Mirror analogy, you can take it up to level, certain level. So right now, the mirror has become very, very clean, crystal clear because of it's a sattva guna.
Correct.
Now, sattva guna, in the sattva guna, there's a reflection, which is actually, you cannot distinguish between the sakshi and the reflection now, because they're absolutely clean. I can't distinguish, because there's no separation. There's no gap between sakshi and anything, anytime, anyway.
Yeah, this is the true image of sakshi.
This is a true image, it's a true image of sakshi, correct?
It's true image, but still image, that is my point.
Correct, true image, but still image, correct? For the purpose of distinction only, we'll say it's the image. Okay?
Otherwise, you know, that is me. That is what I say.
No. That pure image is nothing but sakshi only. Okay?
Yeah.
Now, the mirror has become pure. Right? So, in that, a tremendous amount of bliss is suffused. Because now it's a pure image, the reflection is not distorted.
Correct.
So, that bliss is reflection of Swarupa Dnana. Swarupa. Correct?
Yes.
So there is a dnana. Now this dnana is not vikshepa dnana. It is a swarupa dnana. I am Brahman. My nature is bliss.
Correct.
That's a conscious understanding.
Conscious understanding still of the person who is looking into the mirror. A sakshi.
Sakshi only, no?
Okay.
Right? See, the whole idea is always you are the sakshi only, but you are thinking you are a person.
Yeah, that distorted image. Maybe I'm looking into the mirror and I'm finding myself as a king. So that king is, let's say I'm looking into the mirror and myself as a king or somebody.
Hmm.
Finally, I find myself. I know that is really me in the mirror.
Correct. Real image of me. I am thinking that I'm a body, mind, intellect because my image is showing that.
But actually, I am me, which is my bliss.
My bliss.
So my bliss is completely known as myself.
Correct. And this is a knowledge which happens consciously.
In the sakshi.
What I'm saying is.
Once he knows that, he doesn't need the mirror, right?
No, that is after that, no. See, this happens up to this point, the mirror has to be. See, if the mirror is not there, right? Then there's no way he can, he will not come up again.
He will not know what he is.
He will not know what he is, correct? So now, that knowledge has to happen, no? I am Brahman, the knowledge has to happen, no? Otherwise, what is the point? That knowledge, in ignorance, that happens in deep sleep also, no?
Correct.
In the deep sleep, the Chidabhasa has disappeared.
Even in deep sleep, the bliss is there, but the knowledge is not there because knowledge reflecting surface, Chidabhasa is not there.
Reflecting surface of intellect, mind is not there. Chidabhasa has disappeared. Mind has become subtle or subtler. It is no more able to reflect.
Oh, okay. Is that reflection capability of mind is there?
So now there is no knowledge possible because I go to sleep and I wake up. Right? In deep sleep, I am Brahman only.
Oh, you are right. Okay.
Right?
Now I understand. Why did I go wrong?
see, let me make it more clear, right? In deep sleep, every day we are Brahman only.
Correct.
Because Chidabhasa has disappeared, merged into original.
Yeah, but I have no way of knowing myself because there's no way.
Because instrument is not there, no, mind is not there.
Correct.
Okay. Ultimately, knowledge has to have mana eva karanam manushanam bandha moksha. Knowledge has to happen in the mind. Correct? And what is this knowledge? The knowledge is, I am Brahman, different from the body, mind and intellect. Body, mind and intellect is unreal. This knowledge has to, clarity has to emerge in the mind. Hello?
Hello. One minute. Uma, you're fine? You're fine. Okay.
Right. The clarity has to emerge in the mind only. That is a jnanam. Right? Mithyadnanam has to be replaced with a Satyadnanam.
Okay.
And that Mithyadnanam replacement Satyadnanam doesn't happen in deep sleep. Even though you are one with Brahman already.
Okay. Now I have another question.
No. First let me complete the logic, right?
Yeah.
In Samadhi, as against sleep, the Samadhi, there is a clear understanding that body, mind, intellect are unreal. I am Brahman. Now here I is no longer associated with body, mind, intellect, but it is associated with the pure awareness, which is not an object, it is a subject.
Correct.
So there's no objective knowledge, there's only subjective knowledge. That's why mind, the realization means mind, there is a knowing in the mind, but it's not a knowing. It's a paradox.
Okay.
It's not knowing in the form of object. It's a knowing, but it's a knowing of subject.
It just becomes a pure instrument.
Huh. Right? So, there are two things which simultaneously happen. There's a knowing happening in the mind, okay? That I am Brahman. But it's not a knowing because Brahman is not an object. So, that's why it is said that mind cannot reach Brahman. It said because of it cannot, mind, Brahman is never an object. But mana eva karana manushanam bandha moksha is said because mind only knows that I am Brahman.
Mm.
It's a paradoxical knowledge. It's knowing by not knowing.
Mm. Okay.
This paradoxical knowledge has to happen. Otherwise, adnana will not go. Because every time when you go to sleep, your Chidabhasa has merged into Brahman only. You are experiencing bliss also.
Okay.
So now your question.
Now I've got something. It's that, as you said, the whole understanding, the premise changed a little bit from. So I was now I'm trying to look at where my doubt arose.
Hmm.
I know, I understood this, but so now I'm looking where that Ajnana was. So Uma is very confident in saying there's no Ajnana.
Who has no Ajnana? You don't have Ajnana. Okay, good. You got a certificate. Nobody has given me a certificate.
Certificates are all there, but like the three idiots, that fellow has a certificate on the wall.
So now ask me the next question. What is the question? Okay.
Sutratma.
Sutratma is prana.
It's prana.
Right. That's what my understanding is. Sutratma means prana. That's what my understanding is.
Okay. Then,
is your understanding of Sutratma different from prana?
No, it matches. Sutratma happens at the level of prana, that it is the same prana. Okay. But Pratyagatma.
Pratyagatma is this self in deep sleep state, which is actually prajna. See, we call pradna, okay, and we say pradna is ignorant. Right? We say there is an ego in deep sleep where pradna is there, okay, because he comes up as a, he wakes up as a, what you call as a, Vishwa. Right? We say there is a, we propose, we say there is an ignorance of pradna in deep sleep. Correct? So that actually, there is no ego there in pradna, deep sleep. Because pradna, actually he is one, he is the innermost self. Pratyagatma means innermost self. What is the innermost self? Waking state is waking state, dream state, and deep sleep is. These are only three selves. The innermost self is Brahman.
The pratyagatma means the by definition, it is saying something that is just in front of you. Atma that is...
No, pratyagatma means innermost self. Not pratyak. Pratyagatma means innermost self.
So in that sloka, the first sloka, you go to that sloka of, what is that?
Pratyagatma Swarupaham.
Both Dakshinamurti Stotra and the very first one, we have a definition of consciousness. Where is that? Wait a minute. What is the beginning of the Dakshinamurti Stotra? Show me the Dakshinamurti.
I am opening Dakshinamurti Stotra. Tell me.
No. Let me. The first sloka after the Dhyana sloka. Let me open it here.
Vishwam Darpana Darshyaman Nagari Tulyam Nijantargatam.
Paschandatmani Maya Virmo Bhutam Yada Nitraya.
Correct.
Sakshat Kurute
Prabodha Samaya.
There is a word.
In sloka number 6. Prag Sopnam iti prabodha samaye yaha pratibhidnayate. Right?
Correct.
Sanmatra karunopa samvarano yo bhut sushuptu puman. Prak swapsam, prak swapsam iti prabodha samaye yaha pratyabhidnayate.
So he is saying raukrastat, this is in the state of deep sleep. Raukrastat divakarindra sadrusho maya samachadanat. That when the intelligence is covered like rahu.
Intelligence is covered like rahu. Okay, right? Sushupta Puman.
Sushupti.
Sushupta Puman. Prag Sopna Miti Prabodha Samaye. Prag means Pradna, right?
Pradna, yes.
Sopsya means in sleep. Prabodha Samaye Yaha Pratyabhidnayate. See, the intellect is covered. That means ignorance is there in deep sleep. That's what he's saying. Correct. Now, I'll put the question: Is there ignorance in deep sleep? The ignorance is in the waking state. Because
light is not there in deep sleep also.
No.
The knowledge is still rahu krista divakar into sadrusho maya samachadanat means like the sun is covered in the deep sleep state. What is covered?
Ragrusta divakarendo sadrosho maya samachadana sanmatra karanopa samvarano.
That means all the growing instruments being not in the deep sleep.
Hmm.
Prat Swapsamiti. I am the Pragna. I am the.
The self knowledge is not there.
Self knowledge. Prabodha samaye yap prati vignayate. So this knowledge, when it is known in front, how does it know at that time?
Let me just. Rahugrasta divakarendu sadrasho maya samachandra. Sun is masked by Rahu, right? That it was existing once the eclipse is over. Sun knows that it was there is no Rahu, there is no eclipse after once the eclipse is over.
Correct.
The man whose senses are suppressed when he is asleep because of the veil of illusion. Right? Man, what is that? Yo abhuta abhuta puman prak sam prabodh samaye. So when the way, see, no. He was in a state of sleep. Sleep means ignorance here,
correct.
Not sleep of not the sleep of deep sleep state.
Correct.
So he says, I was in ignorance because of Rahu, which is actually avidya covering my intellect. Buddhi. So here don't bring the sushupti. This sleep is about the sleep for my own nature, which is adnana. So in waking state, I was asleep to myself. It is not, we are not speaking of the sleep of sushupti. We are speaking of asleep in the waking state, which is adnana. Right? So my intellect is like sun, buddhi. So that has a Rahu, which is actually avidya.
Okay.
Which is covering, and it is because that I am not able to see myself.
Okay.
And
it is not the state of intellect in sushupti, but it is the state of intellect in maya.
So that's why this is from this shloka only. Bhagavad Gita shloka comes. What is that? Nidra and Jagrata, no?
Oh, yogi for whatever is.
For the yogi. For all the people, what is dark night is morning for yogi, and for what is morning for yogi is night. That is actually, this morning and night don't refer to the sleep and this thing. It is a ignorance. So this sleep is sleeping to the self.
Oh, okay. So pratyagatma means what then?
Pratyagatma is not coming in this whole thing. Right?
Okay.
Where is pratyagatma? Pratyabhidnana is coming. Pratyabhidnana is different. Pratyabhidnana is recognizing myself.
Okay.
Right? So the recognizing myself is Sakshi. Sakshi is Brahman. This is the recognition. Who recognizes this? The jiva.
Correct.
Right? Jiva is chidabhasa plus thought. Right?
Okay.
Jiva is identified with the thought. So now thought portion it drops. Dropping the thought portion, it says, I am Brahman because I am Sakshi and Sakshi is Brahman. This understanding takes place. This total integration happens. So this is the drop. This is where grahana goes. Grahana means ignorance goes. Now this has to happen in the fully waking condition. It cannot happen in sleep.
Okay.
So pratyagatma, this is pratyabhidnanam. Pratyabhidnanam means recognizing self.
Okay.
Right? The recognizing self, typical analogy given in the Vedanta, is the tenth man.
Okay.
The tenth man is crying. Okay? Then tenth man recognizes, I am the tenth man. So that means the Chidabhasa is recognizing itself as Sakshi and Brahman.
Okay.
Right?
Okay. Yeah, the tenth man is a good example.
Right? So yeah, now, yeah. See, if you take Chidabhasa as somebody who is different from Sakshi, then the whole concept, it's still there is a duality. So Chidabhasa is the tenth man. He is crying, I have lost. Chidabhasa is in reality is the tenth man, which is Sakshi. So he reckons, I am Brahman, he says, and he raises recognition very clearly, consciously. Right? That conscious recognition is jnana. That's why mana eva karanam manushanam bandha mokshayo. Moksha happens there. But this is not a jnana in the traditional sense. Jnana is always referring to objective knowledge. Okay? So it's a swarupa jnana. There's no object there. I am Brahman, he says. That's why it's called aparoksha anubhuti. So in that aparoksha anubhuti, there's a subjective knowledge takes place, and this knowledge destroys the ignorance.
Okay.
So now this subjective knowledge is knowing by not knowing, because there is knowing. I am Brahman is a knowing, it's a thought, vritti. But I am is not a body, mind, and intellect, is the subjective knowledge. I am the pure subject, this is the subjective knowledge. So, I am Brahman is a pure knowledge, clear knowledge.
Yeah, I am Brahman is a pure knowledge, but I am not...
Where I is not referring to, I is not pointing to any object. That's the pure knowledge. That's why it is mind can alone know the Atma, mind cannot know the Atma. Both simultaneously satisfied there only. It is knowing by not knowing. Because not knowing, it is not knowing because it's not an object. It is knowing because there's a clear knowledge. If there's no clear knowledge, there's no realization. Right? This is where the Vedantic understanding comes. The yogic understanding says, vritti nirodha. You stop the thoughts. Vedanta says, stopping the thought will not lead to knowledge. The self-realization has to happen clearly through jnana. So this is the jnana which is they are speaking of. If stopping the thought itself is jnana, then I can give anesthesia. It's not. I go to deep sleep. That's not stopping. That's also stopping the thought. The stopping of the thought doesn't help. The eliminating of the wrong thoughts, then having the right thought and right understanding helps in realization.
Meditation process. Up to the mind, I can Shabdanurupa.
Rupanu with the Savikalpa Samadhi, Shabdanu with Savikalpa Samadhi. Yes.
Yeah.
Now, next stage to happen.
I
don't know is not not okay. I have to know clearly. That's the knowledge. That is jnana, atma jnana.
Correct.
How? That's where you have to eliminate all objective knowledge there. Object. And you have to say, I am the pure subject. That objective, the elimination has to happen. Neti has to happen. So that pure object, you have to become, it is the pure objective. You become the pure subject. That pure subject is I am, you have to understand. Because you said you still have the body, mind, and other concept is there, still as if it's real. So that is an object. So I is none of these. That none of these is the real I, which is I am.
Intellectually, I can, but why is this not, that's the problem. I mean, I understand what you're saying from an intellectual I'm not able to find difference between what knowledge I'm getting intellectually versus what knowledge I should get realistically.
No, what you are speaking is the I, again you are referring to a subtle form of ego you are referring to. Which is, see, the see here what happens, the clear test finally, right? What you recognize as I is a totally unchanging, it's a very clear I, unchanging I you have to recognize. Unchanging I. It's not unchanging conceptual I. It's not an object, it's a subject. That's the crux of realization.
How?
The only way I can tell you is eliminate all changing concepts or notions of I. Any notion of I is still an ego. You have to empty of all notions of I. And that is real I. So when you say I am not able to recognize, what is this I you are speaking, referring to? See, when you say I am not able to understand, I am not able to find out that you are referring to some I, which is a notion. The real I, right, has no knowledge and no ignorance.
I get stuck there knowing that I am false I.
That notion also you have to drop.
How do I drop it?
Because the seer can never be seen. No, you cannot hold it. The holding is a thought. Right? I'm not saying you hold on a thought. You have to recognize the seer. The seer is not a thought. And seer cannot see himself. Seer can see everything, including a thought.
So, I'm seer is inconceptual for me.
It's not conceptual. It's a real seer. When you eliminate, when you see every concept, every smallest and microscopic concept, that concept, one who sees that concept is you. The concepts change, but you don't change. Nitya, anitya.
Nitya, anitya, yeah. So you are saying at that point still apply nitya, anitya.
You have to apply nitya, anitya. Ultimately, nitya, anitya, satya, mitya, you have to apply till the last point. No. All conceptual level, all ideas, any object you have to finally subtle objects will be there. A notion, I am not able to understand, is a notion, it's an object. When you drop the idea that I don't understand or I understand, that's a total surrender. That's where?
That's where Uma is right from.
No, she is holding on to I don't know.
Huh?
She is holding on to I don't know. So you have to drop I don't know and I know both.
I don't, okay.
So the entire thing is, Shravan Kumar, you have to take Nitya, Anitya, Satya, Mitya, Satya, Mitya, Viveka, all the way up to the final point.
Maybe this is giving the clue. Let me
So all this, any smallest notion also is Mitya.
I don't know what you said.
No, I was in the class actually. I received a message when I was in the class. I could not answer her.
But now she says her meditation is going better. I don't know how.
No, I told her to surrender. Okay, I don't know what she has done. I have to call her because her message came and the class was going on. So basically, Shravan, the key is only Satya, Mithya, Viveka. Very clear. That itself is, and that clarity has to emerge, subdued clarity that I am the self, which is the witness of all. And that's a clear knowledge. That's a conscious knowledge, conscious understanding. That's what I mean. Right? See, what he is saying is Brahman, that means ultimately Brahman doesn't know. So there is no enlightenment, there is no nothing, no enlightenment is not a conscious process. That's what you are trying to say. I am saying enlightenment is a conscious process from the conscious process from the jiva point of view. That's why jivan mukti is coming to picture. Jivan mukta leaves very clear understanding that I am Brahman. He lives in the world. Otherwise, there's no jivan mukti, no? These are all very, very, very fine arguments in the... It's like a court argument.
The court argument, that's right. So, what is... the avadhuta state and...
No, avadhuta, see, avadhuta is a no-mind state. Okay, no-mind means no ego. Ego means one which identifies the body. Now, ego is not identified with the object. There is no purely, no conceptual self.
And Paramahamsa state?
See, Paramahamsa is actually, the meaning of Paramahamsa is, Hamsa discriminates between water and milk. Right? It separates water from milk. The milk is Atma, water is Anatma. Somebody's intellect has become very sharp enough to discriminate Atma and Anatma. He's established in the self, Jivan Mukta. Now the Paramahamsa typically is we speak of Paramahamsa Sannyasis, which is a different, it's a class of Sannyasis. Right, there is a Kutichara, then there are so many varieties of Sannyasis. Paramahamsa is also one Sannyasi. Okay, real meaning of Paramahamsa is one whose intellect has sharpened to such an extent, he is able to discriminate Nitya, Anitya, Satya, Mithya, and always established in the truth.
So, but in biography, these two are same. Jivan Mukta, only Jivan Mukta can be Paramahamsa, and vice versa.
Jivan Mukta is Avadhuta, Jivan Mukta is Paramahamsa also. The Paramahamsa, see, there are various, people use it in very, very, lot of sense, okay? I'm not using a lot of sense, I'm using in the only real sense, the absolute meaning. Avadhuta, okay, a person, both are avadhuta, jivan muktas. Paramahamsa is jivan mukta and avadhuta is jivan mukta. Okay, avadhuta, his mind is immersed always in the self. So his external knowledge is, or objective knowledge is, comes down because his prarabdha karma or vasanas are very less, pending vasanas. So because of that, his objective interaction with society is very, what I'm saying, can be weird. Because he is immersed in the self and his vasanas for interacting with the society is very less. You got what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Ultimately, the difference between the jivan mukta is only with respect to prarabdha karma, residual prarabdha karma. Once prarabdha karma is zero, he is already in the Brahma varishta state. He cannot function. So now, all the jivan muktas are in one of these levels. Brahmavid, Brahmavara, Brahmavarena, Brahmavarishta. Brahmavid has some of the pending vasanas. He has jnana. The pending vasana is to serve the society, loka kalyan, the vasanas are more. So he is outward. So Brahma Varishta has outward vasanas are very less. He is always immersed in the self. So the avadhuta is typically comes in between where his outward behavior is erratic for the people. People think, oh, he is behaving erratically. Right? His behavior is not fitting into social order. The social order is four types. Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra is social order. His behavior doesn't fit into any social order because he is immersed in his self. He is Brahmadna, Jivan Mukta. But Jivan Mukta, whose vasanas have come down, social vasanas have come down. That's why he is called Avadhuta, because people see he is not fitting into any behavioral pattern. He can be Brahma Varishtha, he can be Brahmavid. He is more than Brahmavid. He can be anywhere in Brahmavid to Brahmavara, Brahmavarena, Brahmavarishtha. Okay. So Brahmavarishtha typically, a sign of a Brahmavarishtha typically, he has no desire to move around also. He'll sit some one place. Okay. That's why Avadhuta keeps moving also. He is not in the Brahmavarishtha category in that sense. He keeps moving around, but without any, he's not bothered with dress or anything. Because social vasanas, he don't care. Okay. Whereas, Paramahamsa is an order of sannyasin.
Okay.
Right? It's an order. Sannyasa is an order. So, there is a, what you call as, Saraswati, Kutichara, then what you call as, somebody who keeps wandering, you know? Parivrajaka and Paramahamsa. Paramahamsa is the one category of sannyasins who is considered as he is more established in Brahman in the sannyasa order. Okay? Whether Paramahamsa or Avadhuta, both are Jivan Muktas. Their degree of vasana and manifestation is different. Paramahamsa has sannyasa vasana because he will wear a sannyasa dress. Okay, he will have a danda, he will sit in one place. And he will follow some of the sannyasi niyamas, whatever sannyasi niyama he has taken earlier. Whereas Avadhuta doesn't care for any order, even sannyasa order. Brahmana, Kshatriya, what is it? Brahmacharya, sannyasa, grahastha, vanaprastha, sannyasa. This order he doesn't even care. Paramahamsa still follows sannyasa order. Right? But see, we should not bother about this physical appearance. We should always use goes to the root meaning of Paramahamsa. Paramahamsa is a great swan. Hamsa is a jiva. Paramahamsa is a supreme jiva because he is able to separate milk from water.
Okay.
That means Paramahamsa has developed his discrimination to such an extent that he is able to discriminate between Atma and Anatma.
Okay.
And he is established in Atma. That's all Paramahamsa means. Then people call Paramahamsa based on his social sannyasa order. Oh, he has already Kutichara, then Parivrajaka, all this over, he is Paramahamsa, that will say. Okay? See, many people give this, what is that, from external appearance they say something.
Okay, but that's not what.
The real meaning we have to always go. Sannyasa means Samyajnyasa, not the dress. Paramahamsa means one who is able to discriminate. Right? See, there is a sannyasa means he has kept his mind on the self. Okay? Parivrajaka means he has kept his mind on the self, but sannyasa means he is not at attained. His mind is always focused on the self. Paramahamsa means he is already discriminated, he has recognized the self, which is Jivan Mukta. Boss, this is my understanding, okay? I don't know whether it's...
Fine. Understanding, but your understanding also must have come from some reading and some analyzing and then categorizing, right?
Yeah, I read some text, then I understand what they are saying, then I go to root meaning.
Sutratma is that.
I am So that is the innermost self. Sutratma, okay. Of course, Sutratma also means prana for one sense. Sutratma means like a thread. It's like a thread which runs through all the bodies.
Krishna says he is Sutratma.
So that Sutratma, right, is recognition of self in all. Okay,
yeah.
That Sutratma, self in all, means, okay, now he is identifying himself with the existence, which is manifestation. It's Ishvara.
Correct.
Right?
Yeah.
See, when I say I am in all, that means I have to recognize the manifestation. All is nothing but manifestation, right? All this.
Correct.
So, I am in all means I am in all as existence, Astitva. Right? The tree exists, plant exists. I am the existence in all. That's the Sutratma.
Correct. So the next level, Pratyekatma, is the one who recognizes himself as the one who is not any of all these things.
Correct. In deep sleep, what happens? See, in Mandukya Upanishad, the Pratyekatma, he speaks of Pratyekatma. I am Atma Brahma when he says, I am is the Pratyekatma. The Pratyekatma there he is referring to, he touches his hand, chest, and says, I am Atma Brahma. He touches his chest. That individual self he calls his innermost individual self as Pratyekatma. Okay, what is innermost individual self? So you know the self in the waking state, self in the deep dream state, self in the deep sleep state. You don't know any other self. The deep sleep self is non-dual. It exists non-dual bliss. Okay, but you don't know that non-dual bliss, the one who is experiencing non-dual bliss is the Brahman, that you don't know. Okay, there is still an ignorance. So the Pratyekatma there is Sushuptatma, the one who is sleeping, which is actually nothing but Pradna.
But then in this explanation was not given, this explanation given is that he is the one who knows that he is connected with any of the...
No, that explanation is correct only. He is not connected with anything because in deep sleep, you don't have body, you don't have mind, you don't have intellect. Okay, but you have bliss. But the bliss, the I am Brahman, the knowledge is missing.
Okay. But he is conscious.
He is conscious of his bliss. He is blissful. That's why when you wake up, you say, I am blissful. But you say, I am Brahman, you don't say. Every day, Pradna, what we call as Pradna, is Pratyekatma.
Okay. But Baba says this is a path of a person who is progressing from certain planes to the mental plane.
No, this is not a path actually. This is day-to-day experience. That's why in Shankara Bhasha or Mandukya Bhasha, Pratyekatma is given a very clear importance.
Okay.
See, basically, here, see, the Mandukya Upanishad, no? It doesn't take any special state of any sadhaka. Right? It only speaks of your day-to-day experience. And then from day-to-day experience, it shows what is the reality.
Only the three states of...
Because Mandukya Upanishad very clearly says, okay, the reality or realization is every common man's right. If you bring, I am a sadhaka, I have attained this state, that means it's not in the common man's experience. You make that person special. So that's where the Pratyekatma is not a state of a sadhaka. Pratyekatma is your natural state in deep sleep.
Okay.
Right? A sadhaka may find himself as a blissfully asleep in some state of sadhana. That's different. But, see, we have to attain realization, understanding our day-to-day experience. We should not look for any special state. Right? Any states, special states and special experience of sadhana, we should not even bother. Because they are all mithya. The realization or understanding has to be universal and for all the people because everybody, every jiva is Brahman only.
So Pratyekatma is also in mithya, is also told there.
No. Pratyekatma is not in mithya. Pratyekatma is nothing but Brahman. Because the Chidabhasa has merged with the Brahman there. But from waking state point of view, still you are not attained the jnana. You call that state as ignorance. That's why you call it as pradna. The ultimate jnana has to happen in the waking state through discrimination.
Oh, okay. And then the last state is actually knowing that the Paramatma.
Huh? No, see, this Paramatma is another concept. No, Jiva is Brahman. Brahman is Paramatma. Brahman is the self of all.
Yes.
Right?
So you're saying Paramatma is just another name for Brahman.
Uh-huh. Paramatma is nothing but another name for Brahman. See, here, see, please understand. The moment you say Atma, okay, you are referring to individual.
Correct.
Correct? Paramatma means the supreme self, which means Brahman.
Okay.
See, we cannot bring layers there. There is one more layer. So, Mandukya Upanishad says, I am Atma Brahma. This self is Brahman. This self, where he says, he is referring to individual, the innermost self.
Yeah.
What is the innermost self? He is in the innermost self. I cannot tell some self which is, I am not experiencing. I have to tell about self which is experiencing.
Hmm.
The self which I am experiencing, bliss in deep sleep, is the innermost self.
Hmm.
So, that self is Brahman. He is taking your own experience and telling you what is Brahman. You cannot tell about Brahman which you don't understand. Your deep sleep state of self is nothing but Brahman, he is saying. Pratyagatma. So this is my understanding. It is right or wrong. This is my level of clarity. No, no, what I am saying, see here, the Vedanta, one beauty of Vedanta, especially Mandukya Upanishad, it goes by pure jnana, it goes by pure experiences which you can relate and from that only it will point out. It doesn't make the spiritual journey as a sadhana. Oh, sadhaka in this stage he realized something. That you have to be clear. Whenever Mandukya Upanishad speaks of something, it is always sarvatrika, common man's knowledge. So pratyagatma is common, it must be common man's knowledge, not a yogi's knowledge. Got it?
Yeah.
So basically the Mandukya Upanishad makes the entire spiritual enlightenment as a common man's birthright.
So why people say Raja Yoga is different from Jnana Yoga?
See, Raja Yoga traditionally, okay, see, this is again sort of this is again some, what I'm saying is a branding. Okay? Raja Yoga means royal path. Correct? Royal path for enlightenment is jnana. Correct?
But
traditionally, traditionally, some people have started using Raja Yoga for Yama, Niyama, Asana, Pranayama, Dhyana, Pratyahara, Samadhi. So the last four stages.
Jnana Marga. Yeah.
Jnana Marga. Okay, that they call it as Raja Yoga. Okay, in fact, Raja Yoga is only one, which is Atma Jnana, which is Atma Vichara. Right? These are all nomenclature, which make confusion in the nomenclature.
Okay.
If you ask what is common man's parallel in Raja Yoga means, so it's a meditation. Okay?
Meditation
is Raja Yoga. That's typically.
Typically, yes.
Okay, but Raja Yoga, we have to go to the root understanding. Raja Yoga means royal path. Royal path, what is royal path? When king moves, everybody walks away, no? They give him the path, right? Nobody will come in the path.
Yeah.
And what is the royal path? It is only jnana, atma vichara.
people say jnana yoga is trying to understand.
No, see, this, there's a lot of, terminologies, rudartha and gudartha. Rudartha means colloquial meaning, and gudartha is inner meaning. Inner meaning, you should not go to Rudartha. So if I write a commentary on Bhagavad Gita, I'll bring this clarity. to the extent what I understand, okay? I will put a disclaimer. This is what I understand. Raja Yoga, Raja Guhyam is Raja Yoga means royal path. It's dana only, ultimately. Because they're all unnecessary. See, I'll tell you one thing, someone, okay?
The moment I hear this, I see something else, I say, this is that the same as this, how is it compared?
No, I'll make it very clear, someone. The Vedanta, okay, tells enlightenment or liberation is a common man's experience, it's not a specialized experience of anybody. Okay? This realization doesn't happen because you have some experiences. Realization happens because you have a clarity of what you are. That comes Viveka and Vairagya, that's all.
Yeah.
So there is a distinction between, okay?
The point is every time I think, oh, I have the clarity now.
See, Vedantic knowledge recognizes yogic knowledge. So that's called yogi aparoksha. So yogi has some vision, some deeper experiences and all. They don't deny that. Okay, there are people, gifted people, they have some special experiences, some sadhana they have done, there are some experiences. That's accepted. Okay. But ultimately, realization is sarvatrika jnana, not special experience. Means everybody's common experience. Right? Which means you are not a special person. Everybody is same. Only speciality you have is your intellect you have sharpened to understand realization. You get the realization.
Okay. This is a Buddhi Marga.
Huh? This is?
Buddhi Marga.
This is what Marga?
Buddhi Marga is.
Jnana Yoga. Sankhya Yoga. Jnana Yoga. Or
yeah,
Atma Vichara. Atma Vichara.
Sankhya Yoga. You are right.
So that doesn't require any special knowledge. It's not looking for any special experience because all experiences are considered as mithya. Even the highest experience of God relation also is mithya in that level.
Not at all.
Because it gives me clarity also, no? Because I understand something, unless I check, unless that is questioned, I don't know what is real or not, no? Because I don't have any other exposure.
Sometimes I think you are more focused and lucky because you don't have this exposure. Mind is, you know, it wants to know.
For me, I don't know. Was for me a very crystal clear question. Only one question was how the mind can be silent. That's all. Every theory didn't matter to me.
Yeah. For me, the mind is the one which is ruling. And it wants to know with clarity. It wants to know with clarity. And when it is silent, it says, okay, now I'm silent.
Yeah. Your mind is saying silent.
Basically, that's what Shaker says. Okay. One player and says, yeah, I'm silent now.
Right. Anyway. Shravan, what is right or wrong? I have got some clarity and I am saying this is clear and I don't bother too much. This is the clarity which I have got.
Yeah. So, see, once your clarity is there, that's the experience. You know, finally, who cares for all this?
Right? For me, nothing confusing.
No. There's no confusion.
Yeah.
And that is what is the real thing. In between all this confusion. Confusion is in such a way, it is clarity in confusion, but not just standalone clarity. clarity in confusion.
Confusion. Oh, God.
So I'll have some confusion, then I'll have some clarity. I have confusion, some clarity. Confusion is clarity. But the clarity is of the confusion.
Clarity is not of the reality.
Not of the reality. So that is how life is going on. I don't know how long it will go on. Anyway, I hope somewhere, sometime your clarity will come to me.
I can donate as much as possible. Every day I claim to donate. Chidabhasa is real. Chidabhasa is real. It's not unreal. If Chidabhasa is unreal, then there's no realization at all.
Let me absorb and assimilate that in reality. You see, in talks, it is very clear as a concept.
No, see, all this will be concept until you hit that bullseye, no? Right? Until you get the reality, all things are concept only. You have to hit that bullseye. That is a key. You have to get the prize. But the problem is, the prize is you. There is no bull, there is no I.
Until you hit your own eye.
Until you hit your own eye. That's
your bull's example is very good.
What is it? Which example?
This is what the bull's example is, that is a thumper. Somebody or this is happening.
correct. buffalo example, right? See, Atmadhan is like that only. It is only speaking of you. Now you are going all round and thinking that somebody else is gone. Okay, then you say you are Brahman. Then you say, oh, Brahman means so much of realization required. Some sadhana is required. Somebody is in advanced stage and all. So all are concepts. So that's where I like this Vedantic teaching, especially Mandukya Upanishad. It goes straight to the point. What is the point? There is no point. There is no point. It is you are the point. You are searching for a point. There is no point.
That
is the point. There is no point. There is a point. See, very simply, there's no body. And there's every body.
So that inversion view, that inversion view, that in body there is energy, in energy there is mind, true energy, there is a mind. In the mind there is consciousness, is all inverted.
Inverted. Yeah. It is reality.
In reality, it looks good, but from where I am, that inversion is only becoming the concept, but not.
Correct.
Like Fourier transformation. Fourier transformation very clearly.
Uh, I never, this Fourier transformation business never got into my head, but this Atmandana I got into my head.
Okay,
good night.